Good day. I'm Alex from the School of Civil and Environmental Engineering, and today I'll be sharing some insights into flood risks in a warming world as a form of a dialogue between a farmer and a climate scientist. G'day, Mr. Climate Scientist. I'm Steve-O from Dubbo, and I want to know why it's been raining for such a bloody long time, mate. First, it doesn't rain for yonks with them El Ninos and all, and now these floods. They're causing havoc to my crops. Crikey, why can't you Jongo climate scientists get the weather right? With all due respect, sir, the weather can be highly unpredictable, but these recent floods may be part of the natural climate cycle. Cycle? What bloody cycle? Are you bad income? Please allow me to explain using figure one over there. Cycles are part of nature. For example, the Ice Age was part of the Milankovitch cycle, the major wars were cyclical, and even the global financial markets go up and down. So floods like the ones in Victoria at the moment are no different, and there are periods of intense or heightened flood risk. It's true. So these floods must be due to all those bloody large storms all of a sudden, eh? Not exactly. The frequency of the largest of storms or extreme rainfall events alone do not fully explain observed flood cycles. Strangely, they remain constant over time while flood cycles are periodic, which begs the question, why do floods change but not extreme rainfall? To address this issue, we looked at catchment wetness conditions to see how floods responded to rainfall. Applying statistical tests to rainfall and streamflow data from sites across Australia, we found that while the frequency of the largest of storms alone did not change, the general pattern of rainfall changed according to climate state. For example, figure 3 there contrasts the typical rainfall pattern during the dry and the wet cycles. During the wet cycles, we get longer drawn-out spells of rain prior to the intense, short intense bursts that do not change. As a result, the soil in the catchment is in a much wetter state prior to these large storms, and therefore the catchment no longer absorbs all that rain like a large dry sponge, instead allowing it to flow right through to the catchment outlet, causing larger floods. This phenomenon is especially strong in East Australia, which includes Dubbo, I'm afraid. Holy smokes, so when is this wet cycle going to end? I mean, the dams are getting fuller than the state school hat rack. Unfortunately, the climate models are uncertain as to when the wet cycle will end precisely. But of more concern to us all, Steve, are how these wet cycles will evolve into the future. We're currently researching into how global warming may intensify or prolong these cycles of flood and drought. Holy smokes, global warming? Tony Abbott just dropped my petals last week and told me that climate change was absolute crap. Not necessarily. In fact, it's a scientifically proven concept. But if you're not convinced, please drop by our UNSW Hydroclimatology Group and they'll educate you all about it. Thank you.
To top that.